Hey everyone, it's Will, Gamer Dad, with another video for you. So I really should be going to bed at about this time. However, I can't stop the obsession of taking down yet another optional boss. This time, it's the one that's resistant to earth and is weak to wind. Now, if you haven't already, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. I also do have a Patreon account for those who want to support me this way. So again, all these geometric artificial spirits do have random types of moves. You can see that the first one is re-establishing the earth zone, which is very uncomfortable since I only have one wind zone setter. It also has a fixed kind of attack where it goes 1,000. If you allow the battle to go on and RNG still does its thing, it can become 2,000, then 3,000, then 4,000, and unfortunately this is not mitigatable, so you can't prevent that damage and you'll just eventually die. Not only that, when it re-establishes zone, it puts up a 30 hit shield, and it can also do Amorphous, which puts up 100% shield for 2 turns. And so it gets very, very annoying that this Earth one is quite tanky. In terms of dying, you'll see later on in the video exactly what happens, but essentially if it re-establishes zone over and over again, and you don't have any dual zone setters, and all of these elemental artificial spirits are best served if you have 2 elemental zone setters. So in this case, AS Claude and AS Vayna together would actually be best. Like all of these fights, they also have a 50% HP stopper. And So being that this one does have a 30 hit shield from time to time while re-establishing Earth Zone, highly recommend you bringing a team that has multi-hits. So for example, obviously Felmina, with Manifest, you have AS Suzette. Iska is a crit setter, and you do have Yuri as a backup crit setter just in case. Keep in mind that we also, with Manifest with AS Iska, you do have all equal just 30-30 dual debuff, which really serves you well against some of the more powerful attacks. Note that the Earth AoE didn't do nearly that much damage on me, just a few hundred damage. You're more worried about the RNG of resetting Earth Zone, for example, or the 30 hit shield, or just the 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. In terms of status, this one doesn't seem to have as many status effects as the previous 2 super boss fights that I fought. So in terms of worrying about, for example, guaranteed pain or poison, not too much there. Like I said, it's just more frustrating that if they put up shield after shield and then reestablish zone after zone, and you don't get the right movement of your units, especially if you have only one wind zone setter like myself, you're in for a really rough time, either running out of MP or eventually just getting RNG to death. So you can see that this is the second round. I did get hit for 2,000, and you cannot predict the sequence of which these moves hit, being that they are totally RNG. So you can get the 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 in quick succession, or you can have it spread out. Yuri actually does very well because it does have a 1,500 fixed heal plus 25% type shield. So works very well as an auxiliary healer to Meryl, since Meryl will not contribute to your wind zone to power up both your AF bar as well as the damage. Remember that at the end of turn, AS Claude does boost the entire team by 10% per wind move done that turn, for a total of up to 40% extra wind damage for your team. Your best bet is to keep your dual debuff on with AS Iska if possible. And of course, using Yuri to cast Guardian Shield or some other healer, Dunaris will also serve you well. Note that again, we just got re-established for Earthstone and we got that 30 hit shield. So another frustrating layer of RNG yet again. We are running lower on MP. And being that Earthstone is in play, that single hit Earth type attack was 2,200. I'm not efficient enough to change back zone quickly, and so I had to use Meryl to come in for her type shield VC of 35% and then re-establish zone with AS Claude. I did not try actually using a weapon zone setter as my second zone setter, and the reason why is I'd have to really tailor my wind team to be, for example, all slash, for example, putting in Azami and then maybe using a slash zone setter, something like if I did have AS Alulu, which I don't, something along those lines. So you could actually try that if you have a varied team. And yet another layer of RNG again, we have that two-turn super shield, physical and elemental resistance. And so, this is what I mean by really having to land a lot of zero hits, even against weakness. And you're just watching out for a lot of those AoEs, such as Void Galaxy, which is an Earth AoE magical attack. Hopefully, having the zone in play plus dual debuffs is enough to keep you alive. And like I said, Guardian Field really does extremely well here. Also, Ea Suzette, of course, with Manifest, can use Exquisite Blossom to land 4 hits once you've powered up 3 stacks using Elegant Cavort. And so, not only are we wearing down that 30-hit shield, we're waiting for that other shield to disappear. And, nope, see? Reestablished again, Earth Zone, and another 30-hit shield. You can see where we're going, right? Now, my oldest son, aka Jeff Morrison, and he's been fighting these bosses on the side as well. He'll probably be uploading on his channel sometime in the next couple of days. He's already beaten this one. And he's like, oh, Dad, why didn't you beat it so easily? It's only 3 or 4 turns. Guess what? He didn't have those multi-hit shields, multi-reset zone over and over and over again. And for me, it's just frustrating having him say that to me while I'm struggling against this boss, which should be easy since I actually do have a fairly strong win team. So don't get too frustrated if you are losing or get stuck on this battle. Even though you don't get a lot of damaging hits, you can see it's just a lot of shielding, waiting for the shields to come down, hoping and praying that you don't have another Earth Zone reset, and surviving until then. If you do have Meryl and you cast Pure Cradle with Manifest, it does regenerate 20 MP per turn. However, in this case, I really want to have as much as possible now that we have it all set up. Okay, so that's a third hit, and you can clearly see RNG did not treat us very well. We've lost Aeas Claude as our only zone setter, and now we're forced to hope for the best in our second when we VC in our fourth unit. Keep in mind that if the boss didn't re-establish zone at least once, or didn't re-establish the third, the two-turn full shield, we would have ended this battle a lot earlier. And so, if you reset the fight, or you just get killed, the next round might be easier. Alright, looks like we have everything in play. Keep in mind, we do have a 15-hit shield to get rid of first, and then we'll start doing the damage. It's because it's very, very good as our crit setter. However, she doesn't do a lot of hits, and so against a boss like this, she might not be your best choice. However, her dual debuff is something to be reckoned with, and I would still highly recommend her for that purpose. But like I said, if you have that 15-30 hit shield, you'll be like me where you do this large AF, you're doing tons of damage. I mean, we have lots and lots of grass stuff, and look at that, we ended it. Or did we? Of course, the boss still has one small sliver, which you can't see on the pixels, and I lost another unit. So, similar to the other two fights, unfortunately, there were casualties as we were beating the boss. Nothing can be done about it. I don't feel that these bosses are skill-based. You just kind of have to mitigate what you can, and well, we won with 2/3 of our team, and we lost 2 units. For our troubles, though, we do get a Power of Quake Grasta, a Gold Badge, and some Krotos Stones as well. So let me know in the comments below how you are faring with these elemental bosses, whether or not you're having fun, getting frustrated, or a combination of both. Here's my Grasta loadout as usual. Definitely highly recommend using all Pain Grasta if possible. You have Pain Setters in Felmina and Iska as well. We have Meryl as support, healing, and VCing an elemental shield. Of course, Claude AS. This is not optimized Grasta, so we didn't rely on him for DPS. And same with Yuri. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.